Today, we're diving into a topic that I get asked about constantly. Why do you keep coming back to Webflow for your web development projects? Well, by the end of this video, you'll have a crystal clear understanding of why Webflow is my go-to choice and how it can benefit your projects too. But we'll also explore some situations where Webflow might not be the perfect fit for everyone. I've built lots of Webflow sites throughout my career, including a Webflow site for Nick DiGiovanni, a celebrity chef on YouTube. Now, if you're part of the No-Code MBA community, you know that we have an in-depth, comprehensive Webflow course inside the member area. If you haven't joined us yet, be sure to check out the link in the description to access the full course and take your Webflow skills to the next level. So let's kick things off with the reasons why I absolutely love Webflow. First up, design, freedom, and customization. Webflow's designer gives you unparalleled control over your website's look and feel. You can create custom animations and interactions without writing a single line of code. I highly recommend checking out Webflow's templates, where you can see what some incredible designers have created with Webflow. Next, let's talk about scalability and performance. Webflow sites are built on clean code that scales with your needs. There are really large Fortune 500 companies that trust Webflow for their websites, which makes me feel really comfortable that my website is going to stay online and scale really well. Webflow's hosting infrastructure ensures fast load times and reliable performance, even for high traffic sites. Now, let's dive into the CMS and dynamic content. Webflow's CMS makes managing content a breeze. You can create powerful data-driven websites without getting bogged down in complex databases. It's really helpful for anyone who wants to build dynamic sites without the headache of having to deal with a cumbersome database in the back end. So just to paint a picture for you of what this means, let's say you want to build a blog on your Webflow site. You can have a dynamic database in the CMS of Webflow of all of the blog content, and Webflow will automatically create a new page for each blog that you have in your CMS. That's just one example of how you can use the CMS in Webflow. Now, as much as I love Webflow, it's important to recognize that it might not be the best fit for every single project. Let's explore a few situations where you might want to consider other options. First, if you're building complex web applications with advanced backend functionality, logic, and data processing, Webflow might not be the ideal choice. In those cases, platforms like Bubble or even traditional coding could potentially be more suitable. Now, if you want to build a simple membership app, I would still recommend using Webflow and connecting another no-code tool like MemberStack to add that login and membership content on your Webflow site. If you want to learn more about how to do that, check out No-Code MBA, where we talk about more about how to build membership sites in Webflow. Next, let's talk about e-commerce sites. Now, Webflow does have e-commerce functionality, but it's not as complex or fully featured as sites like Shopify, where their entire business is e-commerce. So if you want to build an e-commerce site and that's the focus of your business, I would recommend using Shopify. Finally, a no-code website builder alternative to Webflow that you might want to look into, especially if you're comfortable with Figma, is Framer. Framer is going to be a really familiar design interface for people who have already used Figma before, and it has a lot of the similar advanced functionality that Webflow has. So I would definitely recommend checking out Framer if you want to build an advanced website similar to the things I've been talking about with Webflow. I remember when I first discovered Webflow, I was blown away by how much I could accomplish without writing any code. But over time, I also learned the importance of choosing the right tool for each project. There have been instances where I would recommend using other platforms such as Bubble, Shopify, Framer, like I spoke about earlier, based on their specific needs and goals. It's all about finding the best fit for each situation. So let's recap. Webflow is an incredible tool that offers design freedom, scalability, design content management, and seamless collaboration. However, it's crucial to recognize that it might not be the best choice for every project, especially when it comes to complex web applications or large e-commerce sites. At the end of the day, the key is to select the right tool for each project based on your specific requirements and goals. And if you want to master Webflow and learn how to build professional, scalable websites, be sure to check out our complete Webflow course inside of the No-Code MBA members area. Just click the link in the description to learn more and start your Webflow journey today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.